Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Almighty God, you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, to trust in you with all our hearts, for you always resist the proud who confide in their own strength, so you never forsake those who make their boast of your mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
A reading from Ezekiel. So you, mortal, I have made a sentinel for the house of Israel. Whenever you hear a word from my mouth, you shall give them warning from me. If I say to the wicked, O wicked ones, you shall surely die, and you do not speak to warn the wicked to turn from their ways, the wicked shall die in their iniquity, but their blood I will require at your hand. But if you warn the wicked to turn from their ways, and they do not turn from their ways, the wicked shall die in their iniquity, but you will have saved your life. Now you, mortal, say to the house of Israel, thus you have said, Our transgressions and our sins weigh upon us, and we waste away because of them. How then can we live? Say to them, as I live, says the Lord God, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from their ways and live. Turn back from your evil ways. For why will you die, O house of Israel? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the church in Rome. Owe no one anything except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments: you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and any other commandment are summed up in this word: love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no wrong to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. Besides this, you know what time it is, how it is now the moment for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we became believers. The night is far gone. The day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day, not in reveling and drunkenness, not in debauchery and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Christ. Jesus said, if another member of the church sins against you, go and point out the fault when the two of you are alone. If the member listens to you, you have regained that one. But if you are not listened to, take one or two others along with you, so that every word may be confirmed by the evidence of two or three witnesses. If the member refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if the offender refuses to listen even to the church, let such a one be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector. Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, truly I tell you, if two of you agree on earth about anything you ask, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there among them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There's an old gold gospel song that starts out by saying, blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Jesus' love. The fellowship of Christian minds is like to that above. God is perfect in love. The church very often is not. Matthew's church had problems back then. Churches today have problems. That's just a fact of life. In a way, it's comforting. Another way, though, it's very disheartening that it's really gone on for so long. This same gospel was read at one of our front yard Eucharists a couple of weeks ago, and also for the early morning Christians, and it's come up again. Matthew tells us what should be done when there are squabbles and disagreements in the church. He says, first go to the party that's offended you. Don't talk behind their back. Don't badmouth them to other people. Go to them face to face and talk it out. If that doesn't work, you get two or three other people to come along with you and you try to work out a reconciliation. If that doesn't work, you take them in front of the whole congregation on Sunday morning, let's say right here in the center aisle at St. James in the nave. If that still doesn't work, you kick them out. Just kick them out. Let them be to you as a tax collector or a Gentile. Before I go on, though, let's look at where this comes really in Matthew's gospel. It comes right after Jesus is talking about the shepherd who leaves the 99 sheep. Leaves them to go look for the one that's lost. In other words, each and every single person, no matter who they are or what they've done, is of great value to Christ. And it comes right before Peter asking Jesus, how often do I forgive someone who sins against me? Then one other thing, too, how did Jesus treat tax collectors and Gentiles? He loved them. He loved them as he loves all persons. One thing I will share with you this morning is that can drive a priest crazy is nitpicking. Nitpicking in the church, fussing and complaining over minor little things that can happen in church. It's too cold in here right now. It's too hot in here right now. I can't hear. Some of the mistakes are purificator for a corporal on the altar. The sermon was too long today. Whether someone doesn't get their way on the vestry or not. My committee did that last year. Why are they doing it this year? These are things that can drive a priest up the wall, even out of the priesthood. It almost drove me out before I came here. I had an opportunity to go back in the insurance business here in Jackson and almost took it. In Matthew this morning, though, this seems to be much more than simply settling a petty dispute. What's happened here violates a person's being, a violation of who they are as a person, a child of God. And this has to be addressed because it hurts. I wonder who this morning has had this happen to them. How many here may have been hurt or injured by someone here at St. James? How many have been hurt, either intentionally or unintentionally, and are harboring angry or resentful thoughts and feelings? Every one of us has been hurt by somebody else or has hurt someone else. And we will be hurt again, and we will get hurt again. How do we usually handle it when it happens to us? We don't usually follow what Jesus says for us to do. Why go directly to the person who talk it out with them when you can talk behind their back? Try and avoid them at all costs. If they go to the early service here, go to one of the later services. If they see you walking toward them, you can always try and walk the other way. Maybe say to look down and pretend you don't see them. And so we nurture our wounds, nurture our hurts, and we seethe in pain. And all the time, if we're honest about it, it's tearing us apart. Tearing us apart on the inside, hurting us much more than it's hurting them. For a heart stained in anger grows weak and grows bitter, you become your own prisoner as you watch yourself sit there, wrapped up in a trap of your very own chain of sorrow. Jesus has a better idea. Go to the person directly. Try as best you can to talk it out. Before you do this, though, look first within yourself. See and understand what part you may have played, either knowingly or unknowingly, in making the situation painful. And know that I am just as capable of doing to someone else what they have done to me. And look behind the person who has hurt us. Try and understand their past and what's made them the way they are. And look within them. Look within them and see a human being loved by God. The truth is that those who would wound us most often are those who have been most wounded themselves. As I've said before, none of us were born to angels and none of us are angels. And so don't judge the person. Don't judge the person by this one action alone. And one more musical reference to, as Willie Dixon wrote and Bo Diddley sang, you can't judge one by looking at the other. You can't judge a book by looking at the cover. Look at the whole person. Think of the whole person, who they are, not who you think they are. And God knows I need to hear that myself. It's the love of Christ. The love of Christ that keeps us present to others when we want to run. It is His love that gives us the courage and the faith to face someone who has hurt us. It's His grace that gives us the will to try even though we may fail, knowing that each and every one of us have left undone those things which we ought to have done and have done those things which we ought not to have done. And St. Paul has some good words for us also today. Owe no one anything except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. Or as Marion put it last week, I am because you are. We need each other. And especially right now. I will share with you this morning, I believe that we as a parish family of St. James live this love out as well or better than any other church of which I've been a part. This is a wonderful family, but as any family who lives together and who loves together, the disagreements and problems and hurts. So go to someone who's hurt you. Go to them in love, the love of Christ, because without it, you cannot do it. Pick up the telephone, write a letter, don't email, don't text, whatever it may take to try and win back that relationship, because God knows we all need it. Amen. Let us stand and affirm our faith in God in the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all that is seen and unseen. begotten of the Father, God from God.
Prayers of the People, Form 3, are found on page 387 of the Book of Common Prayer. Father, we pray for your Holy Catholic Church, that we all may be one. Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
Praying especially for our presiding Bishop Michael, our Bishop Brian, and our clergy, Marion, David, and Abram. We pray also for those discerning the call for the next rector of St. James, that we might find a faithful pastor for our people. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons,
that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
Praying especially for our mayor, Chalkway, our governor, Tate, our President Donald, for this city, for every city and community, and for those who live in them, as we face the challenges of the COVID-19 pandemic, for the medical community, for first responders, for teachers and their students, for families who are together, and for families who are apart, that we all may find faith over fear. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Praying especially for Adam, Diane Robertson, Allison Graves, Kim Rayner, Kay Green, Carla Camp, Paul Welch, Richard Bailey, Deidre McGowan, Ware and Betty Connor, Robbie, James Crowley, Ruth, Toby McCown, Chris Brickle, Mary Bailey Rivers, Ellen Miller and family, Mary Beverly Noble, Harlan Mills, Susan Bagwell, and J.C. Miller. Are there others? Have compassion on all who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Praying especially for Tom Evans, Barry Lewis, Woolsey Jones, Shirley Richter, Jane Todd, Margaret Fowler, Willie Rowland, Peggy Van Cleve, and all who have died from COVID-19 around the world. Are there others? Give the departed eternal rest. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share your heavenly kingdom.
Praying especially for those in the United States Armed Forces, we remember Charles, Frank Anderson, Frank Finnegan, Brian White, Bill Copeland, William Hill, William Hunsus, Graham Baxter, Gus Carroll, Austin Burroff, Brian Tracy, Rodney Cole, and Austin Bowman, Taylor Ellison, Foster Ogden, and Logan Kanan. Are there others? Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. Let us give thanks and pray for those in our parish family awaiting the birth of a baby, especially Becca Isaacs Byers and Landon Byers, Bailey and Peyton Ellis, Allie and Alex Samuels, and Anna and Michael Crawford. Are there others? Let us give thanks for all those celebrating birthdays and anniversaries. Let us give thanks for the gift of one another.
Accept our prayers and praises this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. Have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sin through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us greet one another in the peace and love of the Lord. Thank you all very much. A few announcements, too. Next Sunday, we begin in-person worship again at 7:30 here at the church. At 9 o'clock in the labyrinth with families and young children, and at 10:05 back here in the church, you need to register. Please register as soon as possible. Also, Christian formation offerings begin next week on Zoom. We have 5 offerings, I think, right now. Christian formation with Camino, Mississippi, with Marion Fortner and Bo Tate leading a pilgrimage in our own state. Also, I will be leading a class on biblical references and spirituality in the music of the Grateful Dead. Abram will be using classes on the young adult for young adults, and Patrick will be offering youth offerings. Children with Mary Nell and the Christian Children's Committee will be having children's classes also. You may sign up for any of these on our website. The search committee has said that nominations are still open until September the 30th. Nomination forms can be found on our website. If you know someone or know somebody who knows somebody who may be interested, please get in touch with them as soon as possible. I can promise you it's a great place to be. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice unto God. All things come of thee, O Lord, and to thine own have we given thee. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, for by water and the Holy Spirit, you made us new people in Jesus Christ our Lord, to show forth your glory in all the world. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord. God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the Word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable to him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection unto your Christ, and bring us that heavenly country where with James and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith, with thanksgiving. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. As you leave this place, go forth in peace. Be assured that the past is forgiven, that the future is in God's hands. Return to no person evil for evil. Remember the poor, pray for the sick, and make no peace with injustice in this world. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and reign with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Amen. us go forth in the name of Christ.
Amen.